All right, guys, Good Boy 32 here. Check it out. So I'm sitting here reloading some 124 grain hollow point. We're going to be testing these out in the Atlas Titan. And I tell you what, man, thanks to my good friend Ethan Manning, who helped the channel out by sending that thing out for competition. I'm really, really appreciative. What's the reason we're having this video here? Well, there's a guy named Ron Berler who wrote an op-ed in the Hartford Covenant. And he talks about how firearms, well, you're not going to be able to get them off the street. There's too many of them out there. You're never going to get the criminals to give up their firearms. Law-abiding citizens are not going to give up the firearms. And talks about all the different mass shootings and yada, 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 and all the crazy stuff in the world. And he talks about how Australia, since they enacted their little deal, there's never been a mass shooting five or more people. And I'm like, whatever, dude. Look at the overall murder rate in the country. Did it go down or did it go up? Let me know. You guys let me know. Put it in the comment section down below. What was the effect of those guys doing an overall confiscation of the firearms in the country of Australia? And the first thing I'll tell people when I say, we should do like Australia does and get rid of the firearms and destroy them and everybody just bring them on in, just give them up. No. This is not Australia. Australia does not have a Second Amendment, and it was built. The Second Amendment was put in place specifically for people like Beto O'Rourke and Joy Behar, who sit there and go, don't tell the citizens you're coming to take their guns. Just show up and take them. Could you imagine? It'd be unreal. And just the other day, and I was going to do a video on this, but everybody and their mother is doing a video on it, is the pregnant lady who defended her family with an AR-15. Boom! Fist bump. And maybe we'll do a video about that later on. But what I want to talk about is this guy right here, Ron Berler. Okay, so let me read this. This is from the Hartford Courant. Today, one can walk into a gun shop and purchase, for instance, a .22, .38, .44 caliber handgun. Most firearms are built to accommodate one size round only. Here's what would happen if manufacturers of today's standard size rounds were outlawed. And I think this has already gone through the Supreme Court or District Court or whatever, when they were talking about you can't limit the bullets. It's like limiting gas. So, for instance, if we wanted to get rid of drunk drivers on the street, let's go ahead and outlaw gas. Or if we wanted to outlaw cars that used gas, then we would outlaw gas so everybody would have to switch to electric. Well, they use the same mentality in this one in that let's say here's what would happen if manufacturers of today's standard size rounds were outlawed and 21 caliber, 37 caliber, 43 calibers rounds took their place. Eventually, gun owners, and this is it, this is the mindset here. Eventually, gun owners would run out of the old ammo and their weapons would become paperweights. Well, I'm going to tell you something. If you've ever seen the movie Jurassic Park, when creatures find a way, you knuckleheads out there, they don't understand, don't know anything about reloading. I guess what are you going to do? Make this illegal? Casting your own bullets, that kind of thing? We'd have the opportunity for a national gun policy do-over, new tougher gun restriction ownership policy, some already favored by the NRA membership. Well, of course. Fresh attention could be paid to newer research, vetted strategies such as universal adoption of smart gun technology and limiting the size of rounds available to civilians. Police and military would be able to keep their current firearms. This is why we have the Second Amendment, you dumbass. Is so that the police and military cannot overpower the general public or the government. Then this is the whole thing that chaps my ass, is that these individuals out there who think the government should have charge of every single thing that we do. And what's the old saying? Those who give up freedom for safety deserve neither. This is exactly the asshole that I'm referring to, that the Second Amendment was designed specifically around and for this guy right here. To use the recalibrated rounds, people would have to purchase new weapons to fire them. Many would object. Why should law-abiding citizens spend hundreds, perhaps thousands of dollars to replace one's gun collection? Gun manufacturers could offer a six-month window. Oh, he's suggesting now what gun manufacturers should do. To turn in their old weapons and receive a partial rebate toward the purchase of new ones for manufacturers and retailers, these sales would amount to a windfall of epic proportions. What an asshole! Jessa Janetta, a senior policy fellow, I'm not even going to get into that. a lot about the circulation. All right, so what they're trying to do, develop a new round, outlaw the old ones, so that, say, for instance, let's see here. This guy right here, a 9mm shield, you wouldn't run out of ammo for it. Well, I got news for you. I would never run out of ammo for this guy. But then you would have to go and, well, I can't shoot this anymore, but if I want to get a new gun, I can go buy a new gun. However, limited ammo, limited restrictions, they're going to tax you, they're going to burden you, they're going to prevent you from everything you can do in order to get that new gun. But I guarantee you, they'll be happy to take your old gun. All right, some dude's over here leaf blowing for the last 3 or 4 hours, and I got to get to reloading here. Got about 1,500 rounds, man. We're going to have a blast. So with that being said, guys, let me know what your thoughts are down below. Ron Burler, that's not common sense, man. That's a pipe dream, and it ain't ever going to happen in this country. Period. I just don't see something like that happening. It's a great idea, though, if you're an asshole. Excuse my French. So anyway, with that being said, guys, comments down below. Give it a thumbs up if you like the video. Subscribe if you haven't already done so. Support the red, white, and blue. God bless America. God bless his men, women, in uniform 24/7 for our freedom. This freedom's not free. I'm Coda Boy 32, and I am fired up. I am out of here. Y'all have a great day.